with just a comment made by PM just last week. You know, IT plus IT is equal to IT, means information technology plus India talent, Indian talent is India tomorrow. The Digital India project is being taken up, pursued very, very vigorously. Of the various components of Digital India is the digital payments. And after the demonetization, you know very well that the kind of thrust that is being given on the digital payment. And right on the board that I can see, many of these things that you can see is of digital payments. So when the country is digitizing in a big way, possibly this accordingly, or proportionately, the risk in cyber risk also goes up in the digital payments area. I can really say that its importance from a simple fact that in NPCI, we have about 930 people, but of the 930 people, close to 70 people are in the risk management. The head risk is supported by five associate vice president, and two of my colleagues are present over here, Mahendra Joshi and Rajendra Valerao. You know, one looking after the information security audit, and the other is information security operations. In addition to that, we have operational risk, the fraud risk management, and the enterprise risk. So risk as a function in all the organizations in the BFSI sector has gone up significantly. If you go to the banks also, the chief risk officer is supported by a plethora of people. And in the information security, if there are several disciplines within information security, in each area there are senior officials supporting them. The level of investment on information security from a CEO's perspective, I would say, there is always an agenda on procurement of a new tool in every board meeting. And that to really board meeting, it has to go, means it is a high cost tool that you are going. And you ask any banking enterprise, any banking institution, in the every board meeting, you will find one or two agenda items would be there, buying the security tools. Everybody is gearing up. And the basic point of my, basic observation is, it has become so very important that the organization in its governing practice has to put information security on a priority, as a priority item. Every board needs to have a risk management committee, and gradually more and more institutions are going for a board specifically for information security. And now we in our NPCI also, we have got a risk management committee of the board. We have got technology monitoring board, but I'm not, technology is a generic subject, but risk management is generic. But at the same time, the almost more than 50% of the time in technology project management committee, in the more than 50% of technology advisory committee goes on information security. We have got, we are now setting up a very high level information security advisory panel to advise the risk management committee committee of the board. So in terms of investment in tools, investment in manpower, investment in building awareness, investment in terms of the organization getting compliant to different kind of standards, like in payment industry, we need to really, PCI DSS standard is something golden, and always to be in really tune to the standard, a significant time, energy, and attention is going because of the inherent risk that is perceived and realized. Last couple of years, the level of fraud that has increased significantly although the level of fraud, you know, cyber frauds in India is much lower compared to many developed countries, still then it has been growing rapidly. And a couple of instances that, you know, it had come out in the paper last year in September, you would have really seen, almost it went on for 2-3 months. And very recently also in banking setup, some really quite a few banks lost quite a significant amount, and that has also been in the news. If you really go deeper into that, why that happened, is possibly you will find that it is really lack of, lack of adherence to standards, lack of adoption of the best practices. So many of the best practices are in documents, but they need to be really adhered to. They need to be audited every now and then. In our enterprise also, really, I'm not really taking pride. Really, we are subjected to audit throughout the year. Throughout the year. There are always two audits going on throughout the year. And in every audit, you will find there would be the observations. And high risk, medium risk, low risk items should be there. We also subject to really now the audits by CERTIN. So CERTIN has also really now has been playing a very, very important role. And now the efforts are on way for creating a CERTFIN, means CERT in the for the financial sector. In fact, I happen to be a member of the working group also. The working group is going to submit the report before the end of this month, really for the creation of CERTFIN. So we have not stayed at really Information Technology Act or subsequent really these amendments in 2008 and various other initiatives, but really the country is moving at a rapid pace, I would like to say, on cybersecurity risk management. Apart from CERT initiative really and CERTFIN, I suppose NCIAPC, really today the, you would have a speaker, so he would also share with you really from the national perspective. I had seen Mr. Name of Mr. Gulshan Rai really being there in the panel, possibly he could not come. He's also really engaging his very, very good time, and from NPCI side, we have been working very closely with Mr. Gulshan Rai and CERTIN. A lot of work is going on. For those who are in the BFSI sector, really, and I presume many of you are, and the banks, RBI has come out with the guidelines, or the 2nd of June guidelines, which is so very comprehensive. I suppose no central bank comes with such a detailed guidelines covering all aspects of cybersecurity. I suppose I just refer to that really, the 2nd June circular, just for the broad headings, if you just see that itself, you would also be amazed at the detailed nature of the guidelines, cybersecurity framework in banks. It is applicable, obviously, banks, but I believe the other regulators have also taken cue from this June 2 circular. The need for bold level cybersecurity policy distinct, how it is distinct from IT security policy, the continuous need for surveillance, IT infrastructure, IT architecture should be conducive to security. It should comprehensively address the network and database security, ensure protection and customer information, cyber crisis management plan, cyber security preparedness, supervisory reporting framework, needs to be reported to RBI, what is the ideal, the organizational arrangements that needs to have, cybersecurity awareness among the stakeholders, and also the boards, responsibility for cybersecurity, and the annexure to the circular, that gives further details. And that goes into really almost, you can say, micromanaging. And also provides a great deal of flexibility for really individual banks to really go ahead for the baseline cybersecurity and resilience requirement. And I know really after the June 2 circular, the banks in India, they had series of workshops, seminar on this particular circular, because the on the comprehensiveness of the circular. Going into the issues like even the user access control management, the patch management, authentication framework, the mail messaging system, vendor risk management, these threat management, how do you handle the storage, media, anti-phishing, maintenance and monitoring of audit logs, and whole lot of it goes on and on like this. I suppose this is you. This is almost like a Bible for the banking professionals, the bank security professionals. The almost, it is a complete book hand list. If it is really, this provides the, not only the, for corrective action, but the preventive action, the preventive aspect of the cyber security. And not that really it addresses the all issues of cyber security, fraudsters are always ahead. But if this discipline and rigor is brought out, this discipline and rigor would help in even the new forms of cyber attack. So closely after that, this RBI circular, you would have really seen those who are in, again, in the banking sector, the IDRBT checklist. IDRBT, based on the circular, it has really to make it simpler for the auditors, you know, for cyber security. Or doing the self-assessment. We ourselves in NPCI, we had subjected ourselves to cybersecurity. So that breaks into different kind of segments, you know, 8 different segments, and with really questions, and primarily yes and no, really to really see how many yes you get and how many no's you get. So on enterprise control, identity and access management, risk assessment for high-value assets, backup and recovery, the infrastructure-related security like network security, server security, application security, the data security, Wi-Fi security, security guidelines for cloud adoption, the endpoint security and hardening of the security, administration, authorization, malware resistance, standard operating procedure for build and imaging, then security monitoring framework, like what the checklist for the security operations center, incident handling, forensics, capability and category details, how the outsourcing pattern. So there are 300 questions, exactly 300, you know, in different categories. So in 300 questions of yes and no. So these two are the very essential items, the Reserve Bank guidelines of 2nd June and the cyber security checklist 300. I'm really telling nothing new. The work, the significant amount of work has already been done. And very recently also in one of the CISO forum, NPCI brought out a white paper, and it is written by our head risk, Bharat Panchal. He is really, and the team, our two of my colleagues who clearly worked here, this Mahendra Joshi and Rajendra Phale Rao, what are the essential, 10 essential tools that any enterprise must have, or really a recommendatory have. This is a white paper placed on our website also. The tools, which are the basic tools that you need to have apart from the policies and procedures, like the tools on firewall. We have really not indicated any really particular branding of any particular tool. Firewall tools, network access tools, intrusion prevention, IPS and IDS tools, APT tools, antivirus and anti-malware tools, web proxy and content filtering tools, security incident tools, anti-DDoS tools, and data loss prevention tools, and various kind of backup tools. So the 10 tools, basic tools that really, and framework that we have gone. So if, I believe that if RBI guidelines with 18 paragraphs, with really about 200 sub-points, with a very detailed descriptions, NPC, this IDRBT checklist of very 300 yes, no type of simple questions, which are but very leading ones, and which really give an assessment. And the 10 basic points of the basic tools, if 300 are there, these three categories are taken. So 300 checklists, items, some 18 paragraphs, some 200 sub-points of RBI circular, and 10 security tools. You know, these are really can be the mantras of cyber security in banking and financial sector. I suppose if we do this much, and if we are in a position to internalize this much, I suppose it is more than adequate. And these things really, if this needs to be inculcated and spread amongst the IT professionals. That is what I would like to share. Thank you very much. Thank you for really giving the opportunity for me, to me and my colleagues in NPCI, Joshi and Valerao. Since we have really quite a few really board meetings coming on Monday, Tuesday, we would like to leave. We are really not in a position to stay, but my colleagues, two of my colleagues will stay for some time, because they have got another for the UPI, Unified Payments Interface, UPI, you would have really heard about that. We have got a steering committee meeting in the afternoon. There also they will have to really do this thing. There also they have started a very remarkable kind of work. Both of them have started working the mobile security framework, mobile security standards for India. We have been leading in the mobile payment in the world. We have really our IMPS, UPI or something on parallel in the world. And we've also strongly feel that is the future. We have got something unique in the country, the Aadhaar. So Aadhaar-based payment system, Aadhaar for eKYC, Aadhaar for the financial address, Aadhaar for authentication, Aadhaar for payments. A lot of work is going on, and you would have heard in the newspaper a lot of reports coming up, and sometimes the mass media people also, they become over-enthusiastic, or they create the fear so much so that people have to really do overwork. So the government is also doing overwork to see the address these issues and concerns and assure everybody that Aadhaar is safe. And from NPCI standpoint, I would like to say our mobile payment system is safe, Aadhaar is safe, the card payment based on last year's incident, we have learnt a lot, and that is absolutely safe. So the digital payment initiative that the country has undertaken, it is on sound footing. We are, everybody is in the, even in the Chandrababu Naidu committee, when it really reviewed the digital payments, many of the chief ministers pointed out that you want to really take digital payments to the people who don't know what is digital payment. They don't know really how to use it, the digital media or electronic media. You are bringing them into electronics platform. Are we really not inviting big risk? So little awareness should be the priority. Even at the chief minister's level, they have taken pains to understand that what it really means for digital payment and the additional risk that we are inviting by taking electronics to the people who would be using for the first time. So although we strongly believe that later in due course of time, people will learn the way they have learnt how to use the radio and the television. Obviously, it cannot be exactly like radio and television. This really, in payment systems, it deals with money. A great care is necessary. But so far as the usage is concerned, it should be as easy as that. So to make it easy, the various efforts are made. So we'd have to really balance convenience and security. Sometimes the debate goes on. If you make it too secure, it is so inconvenient that people can't use it. But it should not be so easy that really it becomes a really less secure and invites a greater risk. So the balancing act has to be done. And I believe banking system is quite sensitive and quite aware of that. I thank the organizers for inviting me and be with you. Thank you very much. We would love to get associated with the future programs of BSF in the security, in the cyber security, in the BFSI sector. Thank you very much. Thank you, the organizers. Thank you very much.
Initiatives.